I'm here with the next speaker, with Ananda Bosma. He's a very, very interesting speaker. He's a visionary public speaker, teacher, cosmologist, writer, and musician. He's around from 1986, giving many, many hundred lectures, seminars, and workshops worldwide. He's also a musician. He produces music in 432 Hz tuning. And now we have the pleasure to listen to his very unique and authentic explanation of what 432 Hz is and what's the benefit of this tuning. And please welcome Ananda Bosma. Thank you.
Great pleasure to be here at Azara, the spirit that is manifesting here. The theme we get into is directly related to entheogens. We've been researching entheogens for quite a long time, since about 1992. The ayahuasca molecule Harmine and Harmaline has a nuclear magnetic resonance of 8 cycles per second. 8 cycles per second is the frequency that connects us all continuously. It links us to the cosmos, to the DNA. So 432 Hz tuning engages this, and so does Harmine in ayahuasca. Different molecules have different frequencies. Iboga has a 10 Hz frequency, pretty close to the alpha range of 8 cycles per second. The future of the music revolution that is engaged in psytrance is where the music is tuned in the exact harmonics of creation of the DNA, so that these loud sound waves are resounding with the body in a way that the body starts to remember its own healing music, and it attunes the body to the planetary heartbeat. In this part of the revolution, there are more and more composers and DJs beginning to tune to 432 Hz and 8 Hz. This is what we shall explore. The research that goes back to the 60s with the extract of iboga or the extract of Beni Stereopsis, Kapai, ayahuasca, and the extract of Assyrian rue called Soma Raja in the Rig Veda. The molecular registration on the brain waves shows a stimulation of 4 to 8 Hz. This is quite significant because when we are in an 8 cycles per second state, measurements of the heart in compassionate love peak at 8 Hz. We're going to look at that in a moment. And when one is in 8 cycles per second, one is in every single dendrite of the brain. Effortless thinking, maximum creativity. Hydrogen, the element one of the universe, 90% of the universe, 92% of the atoms of our body, has a nuclear magnetic resonance of 8 cycles per second. So this is the tuning of the cosmos and the inspiration, the influx, the shamanism, the yogaism, the new foundation, the anthropic foundation of satiates, new awareness, foundational, existential foundation that emerges, the ontological being, through the strong entheogenic experience, emphasizing the strong due to the ego death and pure, naked consciousness, indestructibility is what remains. that becomes the foundation of future humanity. It's happening now amidst us. So the Iboga and Harmine molecules have the frequency of 8 hertz. 8 hertz we use in our music. We do side trance as well. We do it in the rotation for the musicians here, the rotation of the drums, the panning, the low frequency oscillations, 8 hertz. 8 hertz has been documented over 20 years to cure 27 organic diseases in a triple blind setting. So using those frequencies in psy trance is very, very interesting and revolutionary. The other part that we use is the tempo. The psy trance tempo, twilight psy trance, 145 BPM. We use just 1 BPM down, 144 BPM, because the heart at compassionate love is measured, and you can measure this on an application from the Heart Math Institute on your iPod or iPad. 72 beats per minute is the circadian pulse, the pulse that tunes the time of each of our separate organs. All of our organs have their own unique time. They're all having their own unique trips. How do the trips synchronize? How do the concerts synchronize? They need a harmonic tempo, and that tempo is 72 BPM. Double it, and you've got 144 BPM. So 144 BPM is a very significant drum tempo. 216 BPM would be encouraged too, 3 times 72. You've got other geometrical relations that you can go into, we will go into. In this study on the effects of ayahuasca, the 8 cycles per second from theta, upper theta, and lower alpha is demonstrated. For those who are into MDMA, MDMA engages a 2-hour phase entrainment of the brain hemispheres at 8 cycles per second. So 8 cycles per second is the love in action, it is the compassion in action. We want to use 8 hertz wherever we can in the music. Dr. Andrea Puharish from the 70s into the 80s did a triple series of triple blind experiments where over 2,000 persons were continuously exposed to 8 cycles per second. The nuclear magnetic resonance of the Harmine molecule of ayahuasca, remember, and penicilline. Penicilline is what the pineal gland produces, that is the twin sister of Harmine. 6-methoxy-tetrahydrobetacarboline is penicilline. Harmine is 7-methoxy-tetrahydrobetacarboline. Just one atom difference, but their nuclear magnetic resonance is 8 cycles per second. So the study done over several years cured 27 organic diseases by simply 8 cycles per second. The way that the DNA is arranged in its living animate state, the hydrogen atoms to the 4 letters of life in the DNA is an architecture, again, of 8 cycles per second. If you go away from 8 cycles per second, artificially induced in the DNA, let's say to 13 hertz, the immune system breaks down. If you go down to 3.4 hertz, you get cancer in 24 hours. So 8 hertz is the middle tuning of life itself, but also of the universe. It's not just the Schumann resonance. So ayahuasca, somahuasca, and penicilline are the quintessential molecular tuners of all of the other cascade of psychoactive molecules. Because what 8 cycles per second does is it takes chaos, static, physiological karma, as you see with Iboga, but there are studies also with Harmine, where physiological addiction or physiological karma is converted into psychological karma, which you experience as angels and demons, heaven and hell, which phase conjugate and phase cancel. And so you undergo dream yoga from physiological karma to psychological karmic processing and phase cancellation, resolution or healing. Psy trance, in that sense, is a massive emergence of the healing of the species in technological information overload. We are the shamanic pioneers for the sleepers of this modernity, and it has to be accelerated in this way today. The molecules of phenyline and harmine in their construction all have a central resonance of 8 cycles per second. There are different components that build it up from the nuclear magnetic resonance charts. Harmaline also has a nuclear magnetic resonance of about 8 cycles per second. We have quite a few charts with the examples of the building blocks of these molecules. So these molecules are reminding us, especially these ethno-shamanic molecules, and it is known that with long-term use of ayahuasca, the endogenous pineal gland versions of ayahuasca, phenyline, are increased as well. So the sleeping pineal gland is awoken. We've also done experiments with light isolation for 14 to 16 days, producing not only the ayahuasca effects, but the 5-MeO-DMT effects and DMT by the 8th day and some other things. The ancient rituals of the Vedas, which drank Somaraja, Pagunam Harmala, together with 107 other plants, most of which are psychoactive, including 8 psychoactive mushrooms. A lot of those rituals of the 3-day Soma ceremony, the Trika Duruki, as it was called, were done underground in dark rooms. So whole dark room cultures were utilized for the apotheosis. These molecules are keys to apotheosis. This is what we are rediscovering now as the mass of the people and the pioneer of the people. What was covert and secret and arcane, the cup overflows today. It is the shamanic renaissance of each individual in the existential core, being the shaman and the plant being the mandala kaleidoscope reminder of the primordial shaman that one is. Music, the sacred song, the drum beats have always been a part of the shamanic tradition. The Icarus, the sacred songs of the ancestors, the resonate patterns of the sound harmonics that you hear, going back to the molecule creates a synergetic effect. Likewise, in this digital age, we can do that with harmonic music. 432 Hz, for many reasons, is the perfect choice. There's a lot of research with 8 Hz producing 432 Hz, but a couple of years ago, brain rhythm disorders were corrected by 18 months of exposure to classical music tuned not at 440 Hz, but at 432 Hz. If you're a musician, you can get there approximately by going down minus 32 of a cent, 8 hertz down from present tuning. It's the old tuning. You have this tuning in the Rig Veda. We have identified the most ancient manuscript of humanity having a musical system, an intricate musical system that is based on a just-like tuning system of which 432 hertz is central. So the amelioration of psychiatric syndromes through exposure to music individually adapted to brain rhythm disorders, a randomized clinical trial on the basis of fundamental research, essentially shows that the way that disorders, psychiatric disorders, paranoias, etc., are corrected by 432 hertz tuning, but not 440 hertz tuning, by synchronization. Just paraphrase one, the most important paragraphs. The instruments in the study are tuned to the old French pitch of 432 hertz, which corresponds to the harmonic ratio of natural body rhythms. Exposure to the adapted music, 432 hertz, was effective in ameliorating psychotic, anxiety, and phobic symptoms based on the theories of neuroplasticity of the brain rhythms. This intervention may be enhancing brain rhythm synchronization. The brain synchronizes at 8 cycles per second. So 432 hertz as the A note in psytrance, in ambience, with other 8 hertz guidelines like the panning of drums, the low frequency oscillations of the synthesizers, and many other factors together create a coherent synchronization of the brain hemispheres and of the whole body of the DNA tuning, assisting the emergence of a primordial state of consciousness, the aim of shamanism, the aim of the Gnostics, the aim of apotheosis. And we are on a path, an ontological path of apotheosis with gnosis. Now, other research done over 24 years by a group of fantastic scientists studying love, the HeartMath Institute, have demonstrated that when the heart is producing compassionate love, it can change the DNA consciously. We'll come to that in a moment. Any other state except compassionate love, measured and seen, so documented empirically, any other state does not change the coiling of the DNA. Only biological coherence, compassionate love, consciously engaged, and then willing the DNA to coil or uncoil, produces a result. Even half a mile distance away, and 3 different results. This is extraordinary. This is for the first time in history that we have empirical evidence that we are not just genetic biological robots of nature, that with our consciousness using the coherency of our heart and compassionate love, we can change our DNA. This is the transhumanism. It is an internal transhumanism. It is the technology that the plants are showing us and our practice are showing us. These are unique moments. The emergence of awakening mankind in anthropic satience, where we are satiated with biological coherence, so self-aware that we can start to re-engineer the DNA itself in a coherent form of the music that's in attunement to the cosmos. psytrance and ambience is most definitely a great part of that. And there is a secret, it has been secret, a form of revolution where certain composers have been tuning to 432 Hertz and using 8 Hertz. A few of them use this information publicly. Almanoid is one, an aspiring new artist. Another is Merkaba from Canada. What we see in the heart at the moment of love, in endless analysis, is that the heart peaks at 8 cycles per second and produces the golden mean proportion, a fractal proportion that is the symmetry of creation, the symmetry of the DNA, the symmetry of our hands, of nature, what nature uses. It's coherent, it is fractal, it cascades recursively, it's self-embedding, self-similar, it produces synergetic coherence. This is consciousness in action, and consciousness interacting with the foundation of creation itself. I believe the psytrance movement, as the biggest movement of musical history, is moving towards a global song where these harmonics are used and where the drum beats are also synchronized. Time, like the circadian pulse of the heart at the moment of love, will be of key essence. Concerts start at the same time, but use different tempos that are circadian rhythm relatives. The effect of that is that each of the concerts produce a coherent synergy into the resonance of the earth. So as you're going through your shamanic, your visionary, your apotheosis, or hallucinatory state, you are joining in a pulse with the earth grid in a coherent sequence that continues in the golden proportion forever. Furthermore, the forehead is entrained by the heart at the moment of 8 cycles per second. So, for the first time in history, compassionate love entrains the brain in its highest creative form. Effortless thinking, non-critical analysis, instant creativity. And there is resonance in the life force, the chi or ki force. What happens with nature is you don't get 8 hertz, but you get the golden proportion. The extreme low frequency coil shows that the tree sings along with the heart in love, but not in 8 hertz, but in the golden proportion. The golden proportion never ends. It is mirror into mirror into mirror forever. And it is transient to linear time. So the golden mean goes into the future and into the past. So when the heart is consciously in compassionate love, in a shamanic state of apotheosis, that cascade is life before life, life after life, life immortal, the immortal body. The golden proportion. The body is based out of the bud of the golden proportion. So we are in the image of the gold of love, which peaks at 8 cycles per second. Again, the molecular resonance of harmine, penoline, harmaline in ayahuasca and in shamanism. The golden proportion in the galaxy. So we attune to the galaxy, using that in our music to amplify our own coherence, to synergize our coherence, emerging as co-creators with the music and beaming that resonance into the galaxy is the future where we're heading. All healers from different walks of life that are genuine, whether Catholic, Huna, African, etc., are measured to be releasing an approximate 8 cycles per second frequency from their hands. It stays in the water signature for months afterwards. So healing is 8 cycles per second. 8 cycles per second does not have borders. It does not have linear time. I heard some people while they were tripping saying, we are everything. We're absolutely everything. Past, present, and future. Indeed we are, and it's being documented. And the science of this directly relates to the experiences that we are having. 8 cycles per second from the 50s to the 70s was broadcasted through a vacuum. Nothing passes through a vacuum. And copper sheets, a Faraday cage with a vacuum. A triple vacuum, in fact. The only way that 8 cycles per second can pass through a triple vacuum is if it ortho-rotates 90 degrees and 90 degrees through what is called Bell non-locality. That is non-local reality, past, present, and future, non-material. So 8 cycles per second is at the same time a non-material, non-local aspect that is able to tunnel straight through the triple vacuum. 8 cycles per second connects us all. Stop 8 cycles per second in life and it dies within a short period of time. We are continuously here as biological animate beings by 8 cycles per second. So accessing that source code in our song, in our music, in our practice is the renaissance of the new man now emerging in our midst. We are the pioneers of this. This is one of the early Faraday cages. Furthermore, anyone who was put in such a cage was suddenly becoming psychic. They had extrasensory perception powers, remote viewing. They were accurately able to tell which numbers were in another room, and so forth and so on. So by being in an 8 cycle state, the 8 cycle state was also stimulated with negative ions in the pilots, makes one attuned to other levels of information which before were mystical but now are just part of the new harmonic music science. And furthermore, 8 cycles per second passes through a superconductor which normally warps all time and space around it, but that's another story. I have to skip some slides here rapidly. So hydrogen, which is a single proton and a single electron, again 90% of the universe, in every cubic centimeter of the universe, and 92% of our body, has a constant resonance of 8 Hertz. 8 Hertz is the phase velocity difference between the velocities of the orbits of the proton versus the electron. This is the universal heart-mind. This is the universal tuning. So 432 Hertz, engaging the synchronization of the brain hemispheres, then rotating those drums at 8 cycles per second, or 480 beats per minute, which is also 8 cycles, and the low frequency oscillations tunes us directly to the topology of creation and of our body and of information that is absolutely everywhere. It is the cosmic living information system that any advanced species in the universe would utilize. Water has a dielectric resonance of 8 Hertz according to studies already in the 50s through the hydrogen bonds in the water tetrahedron, producing an overall electromagnetic resonance of 8 Hertz times 8 Hertz times 8 Hertz. We are bags of living water. So water is a musical system. So the water in our body can be harnessed through 8 hertz resonance. And when water is electrolyzed for 3 days, just like the 3-day Soma ceremony of the ancient Proto-Vedic people, not Hindu, Proto-Vedic, they were shamanic, they knew the shaman was the greater self, the unity self of each person uniquely. When that was engaged, it was engaged over 72 hours to induce an apotheosis, a metamorphosis of gnosis and beyond. Sterile water electrolyzed for 72 hours produced life, fractal life. So 512 hertz switched on with a musical sideband which includes 360 hertz, 432 hertz, and 720 hertz as the roof. When this switched on, a light, a biophotonic light that Dr. Fritz Popp coined biophotons, switches on. This light starts to produce amino acids. Those amino acids start to form into proteins just from 8 hertz electrolysis. What is the electrolysis in the human experience? It is the rapture, it's the ecstasis, it's that wave where the cascade of the whole body is joining with the cosmos in the peak experience. It is whole body orgasm, that's electrolysis. So in electrolysis of 8 hertz for 3 days and 3 nights, which was the 3-day Soma ceremony, the Tarika Druki, new life is produced, fractal proteins in the Mandelbrot-like fractality. In the studies of Dr. Andrea Puharich, many studies done over a period of time. Now, the work with love became very interesting with the work of McCruti, Dr. McCruti and Dr. Ryan, who demonstrated that love willfully could change the coiling of the DNA. So the DNA might have been animal DNA in the Petri dish. The pilot was measured, had practiced a coherent protocol of deep breathing, feeling compassionate love. It was seen in the biofeedback spectrum, which you can now have yourself as the inner balance application to document it. So you have the empirical evidence of this. And then the focus of consciousness would choose that the DNA would coil or uncoil. And this wasn't the pilot's blood, this was other blood. It did what the consciousness of the pilot wanted. When the same pilot or another pilot was taken, but in a non-coherent state, in an intellectual state, cappuccino state, argumentative state, stress state, and tried to do the same experiment, no result on the DNA. So without compassionate love, we do not affect the DNA per se. The ultimate genetic modification is done by the heart in compassionate love. And that is why the transhumanism revolution is a biological, coherent consciousness revolution. Technology cannot simulate our consciousness engaging willfully biological coherence to produce a different result. These are some of the things that are being pioneered. Even half a mile away, the effects were instant. Furthermore, another study showed that 3 separate results could be obtained at the same time by one single pilot. In compassionate love for a few minutes, focusing on the DNA and willing it to change, to uncoil, to coil, and to change in the middle, which shows that love is a non-local phenomenon. It's a new force, compassionate love, that can produce willfully three separate results concurrently. This is a unique emergence in humanity, and everyone can be taught it objectively. Most of us know it from experience and practice, but now it is also empirical. This is a renaissance in this bewildering world we're in today. The inner balance application, children can use it, and they can use that compassionate love, stress management for the rest of their lives. You use it for a little while, you know what it is, you see its objective, you see your heartbeat going to 72 BPM, the coherence is there, the blood tests have been done, the stress hormones go down, the hormones that support life go up, the various problems of self-confidence and depression, etc., are ameliorated, just as in the studies with 432 Hz over 18 months. So 8 Hz, 432 Hz in the music, plus consciousness practice as you are dancing the ancestors, dancing the Buddhas, dancing the future, dancing the past, dancing the uniqueness that we each uniquely personify, and no one else can personify for us, through biological coherence and anthropic satiate consciousness. So the universe, the hydrogen universe, 90% of the universe is already tuned at 8 Hz. It's the miracle of this matrix. It's the miracle of the grand hallucination, the grand trip of our universe. It's a buried treasure. The buried treasure is our own self-realization. We are unburying that treasure at present. 432 as a number is significant all over the world. It's also part of sacred geometry. If you want to make a golden triangle, which is the sequence the heart magnetic fields produce in compassionate love, you take 360 degrees minus 432 degrees or plus 432 degrees, when seen from the 360 degrees of the sphere. So the golden triangle itself is representing the number 432. You will have noticed meaningful synchronicities in your trips, in your experiences, in your dances, in your gnosis moments. These meaningful synchronicities have intrinsic value. There is a new science that documents that. From the 8 Hz pulse that takes place throughout the cosmos and continuously in our body, an octave of harmonic frequencies is continuously set up. So the C tone is 256 Hz. It's 8, 16, 32, 64, 128, 256, 512. These are all the notes C or Do. These tunings continuously emerge from hydrogen 8 Hz, remembering that 8 Hz is also non-local, past, present, and future, coming from a point that is the summation of every individual in every moment, past, present, and future, which includes our great-great-great-grandchildren who will be building their hadronic space-time machines and will be space-time traveling, re-engineering their bodies to be able to do that through these molecules. This is the first glimpse of that. Darkroom retreats, etc., who will begin to time travel and space travel. The only way to space travel is also to time travel. As a result, the 8 cycles per second is also summarizing that. Hence, your many, many extraterrestrial UFO like experiences in the various trips, where you have the human genome 2%, every other animal is in the other 98%, insects, reptiles, dogs, cats, etc. So we have these kind of interactions, because in the future we awaken the whole DNA using the anthropic sapience, biological coherence, and molecular technology that is interacting with our consciousness to engage genetic transformations, which means the genomes of every single animal that is within our DNA, until we become a hyper-holographic projection. Now we are seeing it psychonautically, where one becomes part animal, part human, humanoid, animal, a trip, you might be an ant for 8 hours, or you might be a reptile for 8 hours, or you might find yourself in sphinx-like states, where you are a plurality of different animals that correlate to your experiences as a human being in some absurd manner that you yet experience and make sense of. These are deja vus of our potentially activating all of the other DNA using our harmonic sound technology with a consciousness compassion. As the Psytrance is playing, I give you an example of, we can turn up the volume. So this is a 432 Hz Psytrance, so I'm 144 beats per minute, twice 72, 8 Hz throughout, the golden numbers of the golden mean throughout. This is part of the revolution, where every level are the same harmonic golden numbers alive and dancing that are in life, that amplify your own coherence and your own healing. This is the future of Psytrance. I believe this is extraordinarily close, it's inevitable, and it's going to lead to something so significant for the human species, where concepts of the planet with the same harmonics synergize together, and we experience through the non-locality of the 8 Hz states our collective consciousness, and personally with others we want to engage the music field itself as the means for contact with cosmic time-traveling intelligences. The scientists have tried. Why shouldn't music culture and art using harmonics, the harmonics of the heart, artists of the heart, heartists, as the dancers interacting together, which means we need to make the sound more holographic, the speakers need to be placed in exact harmonic systems to produce holographic nodes, the body fields of the dancers are brought back into the music through octahedral antennas and mixed in. So the audience is dancing with the song, and that is then linked between concerts, producing a physiological as well as an experiential global awareness and awakening, which should be the beacon that we send to space as a cosmic dialogue. The global song for cosmic contact. It is inevitable at some point for us. What is exciting about this love technology of the heart map is that the top scientist, Dr. Luc Montagnier, right now, the world AIDS expert, is doing an experiment with the HeartMath scientists to teleport stem cell information through compassionate love into stem cell cultures, so that love is the means to stimulate the baby cells. That means, people know what stem cells are here? Stem cells are the baby cells, the original cells of the body. There are new dentist methods by which the stem cells of the mouth will regrow teeth. You can regrow everything through stem cells. But the advanced technology now is compassionate love with consciousness intent, teleporting the stem cell information into another stem cell culture. Consciousness, compassion, for genetic engineering. Before Dr. Luc Montagnier discovered that when you had two test tubes, one with sterile water and the other with DNA, and surrounded it with an almost 8 hertz field, 7 hertz in that study, the DNA teleported into the sterile water. Then he was contacted by the HeartMath Institute, where they were saying, well, half a mile away, we could produce instant changes on the DNA through compassionate love. Now those two are being put together. This means the regeneration of the body into a new form of metamorphosis of the stem cells is beginning to emerge, but not through nanotechnology. Nanotechnology cannot interact sufficiently with consciousness. So the singularity of Ray Kurzweil is a pipe dream. It's not anywhere near DMT. It requires the anthropic consciousness intent with biological coherence. It's not just the 8 hertz. It's not just the feeling of compassionate love. It is the consciousness intent with compassionate love that produces the result. Consciousness is the key. The existential ontological being is the key to this, and it's emerging. So DNA teleported by 7 hertz. 8 hertz is the peak of compassionate love. I'm at the edge of my seat to see what the results will be. Have they been able, through compassionate love, to teleport stem cell information into stem cell cultures? Because when that is confirmed, it means we can re-engineer ourselves, our age, etc. I've seen with very high dose combinations of entheogens, very specific ones, people becoming 10 years younger, and not just for a few hours, but for 10 years. So there is a great deal of evidence that 8 cycles per second has cured 27 organic diseases, triple blind. 432 hertz has been demonstrated to cancel various psychiatrical symptoms like paranoia and schizophrenia over 18 months. The Mozart at 440 hertz at zero effect. So 440 hertz is out of that harmonic range. We need to go back to the old scientific pitch. The pitch that was used by the shamans of Babylonia, of the Sumerians, who had the sacred plants. The Anunnaki are exact botanical plants that are very similar to ayahuasca and natural LSD, LSA. So 8 hertz, 432 hertz is healing, rejuvenating, kindling well-being. As one is going through the chaos of a decompactification of the unconscious subconscious mind in the deep trip experience, so the 8 hertz, 432 hertz helps one find the heart of the vortex to to be able to dance, face conjugate compassionately with the angels and the demons, with samsara and nirvana, to cancel those illusions, to remember what the buried treasure of the illusion actually is. And that's our surprise and unique for each person. It's a better trance. It's a better dance. The trance is the synchronization of the brain hemispheres, the synchronization of heart and mind. And when you get that brush, the life force, the nuclear life, the nuclear magnetic resonance. So it is a better trance. It's a better dance. You're getting the resonance of the nuclear energy and the foundation of the universe. It is the tuning of psytrance. It's attuned to the DNA. The DNA is constantly replicating by 8 cycles per second. So we are then genetic dancers as well as genetic co-creators for the first time, where genetic free will emerges. This is what is happening in these kind of events, says Ozara. It is the tuning of the universe, of the sun and of the moon. The sun has a radius of 432,000 miles. Moon has an equatorial radius of 2,160 miles. Take that 4 times, 4,320. The harmonics that cascade from 432 hertz. There is an exact distance of the sun and the moon to Earth. Take the heart of the sun in the mean of the elliptical orbit of the Earth around the sun 108 times, and 108 times 4 is 432. 108 times you have the distance to Earth. Do the same with the moon. Take the equatorial circumference, the heart of the moon, 108 times, and you have the distance to Earth. Exactly. So there is a language in the cosmos, a harmonic number language in the cosmos. Without the sun, without the moon, there is no life. So 432 hertz and 8 hertz directly links to the symmetry of the life beacons, the sun and the moon. The diameter of the sun, 864,000 miles, is twice 432,000 miles radius. So you've got the number there. Now our solar system, according to NASA, is traveling to Lambda Hercules at a speed of 43,200 miles an hour, 432. Just a different decimal, and the zeros are zero. This is how the geometry of musical harmonics works. This is a unified field of musical numbers. So our solar system is traveling at a harmonic in miles an hour of 432. I can go technical with this, I won't. Take the moon in diameter 2 times, 2160, 4320, old Babylonian tuning. Our time, 12 hours, is 43,200 seconds in 12 hours. So it's a harmonic of time too. We look at Jupiter. Jupiter has 43,200 miles radius. It has 86,400 miles diameter. Like the diameter of the Sun with a changing floating decimal and zero relation. In 24 hours, we have 86,400 seconds. So the numbers are the same. These are the harmonic cascades when we tune to 432 hertz. We are tuning with our cosmic background, our local garden, the solar system starts to become our musical instrument. Going to the local star of Alpha Centauri, which is 4.32 light years. We go to Sirius, it's two times that, two times 4.32 light years, or 8.64 light years. So it continues going. Also to Epsilon Eridani. If you take the galactic center, which we were conjuncting in 1998, and will again in the year 2222 AD, probably a global psi trance like event that is backwashing to ourselves now. The galactic center in parsecs to Sirius is 2 × 4,320 parsecs. So you've got the same number of musical harmonics to the heart of the galaxy through our solar system, our interstellar environment. We are tuning by harmonic musical number dances. Our solar system itself, by Kepler, is a musical arrangement of music, musical arrangement of the golden proportion, which is from 360 degrees plus 432 degrees and minus 432 degrees, the golden triangle. Then rotate that 36 degrees, 36 is very important, and you start to get the pentagram system. Our DNA is based on sugar phosphate pentagons every 36 degrees. So this is genetic symmetry in our solar system in music. The tuning cascades from the orbit of Neptune to Saturn to the asteroid belt where Kepler predicted it. And then the next pentagon in, four, planet Earth, which has 12 pentagon plate tectonics, with the image of life, top-down view of DNA, two pentagons, 180 degrees to each other. So, 432 hertz starts to attune in concerts, especially when they become concerts that are happening at the same time in different locales on planet Earth. Starts to attune to the solar system musical structure. As if we're unburying a space manual to discover the spaceship of our solar system through music and through the unburying of our primordial consciousness utilizing biological coherence, peaking at 8 hertz. 36 degrees between each pentagon. We use 36 degrees in all of our musical mastering, 36%, etc. Here continues to the orbit of Earth. So this is the dynamic musical artifice. This is a beautiful symmetry. This is artificial. This is art. This is art that our heart articulates and interfaces with. When you tune at 432 hertz, not 440 hertz, these are the different harmonic resonances you start to produce, which are very, very important. They contain 256 hertz, which is the equal tempering range. They contain 144 hertz, 72 hertz. The 162 hertz is practically the golden mean. The golden mean is 1.618. So the 1.8 is rounded off to 2. You've got the binomial sequence. You've got the harmonics of 108 hertz, 216 hertz. Many, many factors. The Pythagorean comma, the physics constant, the musical fourth, 153 hertz. So you are cascading all of these multiple harmonics which build creation itself. These are the harmonic ratios by which the dance of creation is constantly dancing. So this is a dynamic tuning to the dance of the cosmos, and then with our own psychoactive consciousness interactivity, it is our own co-creative cosmic dance. These can be placed on what we call the 432 hertz cube. Any questions? Yes?
I'd like to know, if we want to do the many sound system, I know they don't project true frequencies. So what do you suggest? Like, how do you get the true frequency to come through if you want to do live sound healing therapy?
Star system, you said, right?
Sound
is
healing therapy. If
we're
going to tune into like 8 MHz or 8 MHz or 432, how do we get the true sound so it's not a false?
If it's not tuned, you mean?
Yes.
Right.
Like, there's information available on the internet and everywhere, but I know some of them are like saying they are, but they might not be the true frequencies.
The true frequencies, yeah. So this is part of a complex part. The composers who are using VSTs, plugins, are having more hard time than those who are composing with devices like Reactor and Reason. Reason and Reactor make it very easy to tune to 432 hertz. They've made the ability to not lose the quality. Because if you take a song that you really like and down-tune it, you lose about 70% of the information. I've worked with an Italian scientist, Dr. Nicola Lomardo, with the Italian Ministry of Health, and also now at CERN, who was testing a wide variety of our music styles. Some of my favorite songs were at 108 BPM. Unfortunately, the coherency was quite a bit lower with that, so when I turned it back to 72 or 144, the coherency goes up. He used very specific equipment to measure different effects depending on the type of song. Our Psytrance song, The Idiot, for instance, had off the charts coherency, and he doesn't like that genre. He went white in the face with his measurements. It stimulated the circadian, the cardio, the cerebral, and the charge parity resistance to geopathic stress, environmental pollution, or the geopathic fault lines. So the tempo is very important in this.
Okay, if I listen to some side chance that has the right frequency on like a good quality headphone, will I be getting that fast?
That's a good question. The question was, if I'm listening to Psytrance on good quality headphones, will I be getting the effect? No and yes. You'll be getting this, if they're using 8 hertz, you'll be getting the synchronization, you'll be getting the feedback through the somatic system, but the actual resonance to the cells by quality speakers has a different effect.
So unfortunately, we have to stop with the question now because we have to set up the panel, which is going to be in 10 minutes on the same topic. So then you will have all the time to ask questions. So just hold on for 10 minutes. We just have to put 3 chairs there and set up some instruments, and you will have another 1.5 hours to ask questions to Ananda. Please thank him for his great talk.
To the revolution of us.